Good morning, students. Welcome to our fourth video session. Children, we have already learned regarding photosynthesis in our first video session. Today, let us learn the significance of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a very important process for life on this earth. This process helps in the conversion of solar energy into organic matter. That means it helps in the linking of physical and the biological world. The third point is, it is the primary source of food for all living organisms, either directly or indirectly. That means they obtain, all the organisms obtain their food from plants. It also purifies air and also helps in maintaining the balance in the atmosphere, that is the gases of oxygen and carbon dioxide levels. Children, now let us have a practical view of the activities in our lab. Children, let us observe the stomata under the microscope. Before we observe it, first let us see what are the things required. Firstly, we require a microscope, a beaten leaf, slide, cover slip, watch glass, safranin, distilled water, forceps. Firstly, we shall take a leaf and tear it in such a way that you find a transparent layer. Now we shall separate this transparent layer over the watch glass. We shall add a few drops of distilled water. Distilled water is added so that the peel doesn't get dried. Now I'm going to add a few drops of coloring agent called as safranin. Safranin is added so that the cells appear clearly when we observe it under the microscope. Let us wait for a few minutes until the peel absorbs the color. Now take the slide, transfer the peel onto the slide. Now take the cover slip and cover it over it. Cover slip is kept over it in order to avoid the air bubbles. Now our slide is ready for the observation. Children, now our slide is ready for the observation. I have kept this slide under the microscope for the observation. We have to make fine adjustment in order to observe the cells under the microscope. Come, let us see how the cells look. This is how the stomata looks under the microscope. You can very clearly see the guard cells. Now we shall move on to the second activity, observing fungi in red using the magnifying glass. Take a few slices of bread and keep it in a moist place. After 2 to 3 days, you observe blackish gray color substance over the bread. Children, can you observe those black and and grayish color substance.
This is how it looks when you observe it under the magnifying glass.
Children, now that we have observed the fungi under the magnifying glass, let us also know how it looks when we see it under the microscope. This is the structure of fungi. It is called as the rhizopus. This structure has a swollen structure at the top which is called as sporangium. Inside this sporangium, you find another structure called as columella. When this sporangium bursts open, it leaves out tiny spores which are called as sporangiospores. The thread-like structures, these are called as sporangiophore. The connecting structure here you find is called as the hyphae. If we go further down, you can find tiny root-like structures which are called as rhizoids. It is this rhizoids which penetrates into the bread and derives the food from it. Children, I hope you have understood the structure of rhizopus. Children, we shall start with our objective. Kindly refer your textbook to page 12 and page 13. I request everyone to take a pencil and note down the answers in your textbook. The first one, we shall start with our MCQs. First one, the life process or processes that provides or provide energy is are A, nutrition, B, respiration, C, both nutrition and respiration, D, response to stimuli. The answer is nutrition, A. We move on to the second one. Which of these are autotrophs? A, all plants, B, green plants, C, all animals, D, unicellular organisms. The answer is B, green plants. Third one, which of these is not necessary for photosynthesis? A, carbon dioxide, B, chlorophyll, C, light, D, nitrogen. The answer is D, nitrogen. Fourth one, which of these elements is needed in addition to carbon, hydrogen and oxygen to make proteins? A, nitrogen, B, phosphorus, C, potassium, D, calcium. The answer is A, nitrogen. Fifth one, which of the following gets absorbed from the atmosphere during photosynthesis? A, oxygen, B, water vapor, C, carbon dioxide, D, nitrogen. The answer is C, carbon dioxide. Sixth one, organisms that live in or near the host and obtain their nutrition from the host are called A, saprophytes, B, autotrophs, C, heterotrophs, D, parasites. The answer is D, parasites. Seventh one, partial parasites are A, green plants, B, non-green plants, C, either green or non-green plants, D, neither green nor non-green plants. The answer is A, green plants. Eighth one, which of these is a saprophyte? A, Venus flytrap, B, mushroom, C, picture plant, D, dodder. The answer is B, mushroom. Next, children, We move on to very short answers. Look into your textbook. The first one, living organisms that cannot make their own food are called heterotrophs. H-E-T-E-R-O-T-R-O-T-H-S, heterotrophs. The second one, the structures in cells that contain chlorophyll are called chloroplast. C-H-L-O-R-O-P-L-A-S-T, chloroplast. Third one, what does photo in photosynthesis refer to? It means light, L-I-G-H-T, light. Fourth one, which bacteria in the soil can convert atmospheric nitrogen into soluble compounds? The bacteria name is called as rhizobium. R-I-R-H-I-Z-O-B-I-U-M. Fifth one, what type of plant is Cuscuta? It is the parasitic plant, P-A-R-A-S-I-T-I-C, parasitic plant, P-L-A-N-T, plant. Sixth one, what do you call a mutually beneficial relationship between two living organisms? That type of relationship is called as symbiosis, S-Y-M-B-I-O. S-I-S, symbiosis. Now, we shall move on to the seventh one. Name one organism that gets its food from dead and decaying matter. Write down the answer as fungi. F-U-N-G-I, fungi. Eighth one, when iodine is added to starch, it becomes dash in color. It becomes blue-black in color, which shows that starch is present in it. Now we shall start with the ninth one. What is the ultimate source of all the energy needed by our body? That is sunlight. S-U-N-L-I G-H-T, sunlight. Tenth one, saprophytes are green in color. True or false? It is false. Saprophytes are non-green plants. 11th one, some green plants are also heterotrophic in nature. It is true.